Good morning, students. How are you all? Hope you all are doing good. We are learning now stock exchange. We have learned many headings. Today we are going to learn about the types of speculators available in the stock exchanges. Okay, I have told you many that members, speculators, then brokers are available in the stock exchanges. They are named after the animals. Animals' name, as per their motives of trading, in the stock exchange they are grouped under different names of animals. The first one is bull. This bull are tejwala. They are also called tejwala. Here, this tejwala, this operator, he expects a rise in price. As per their motives in the stock exchange, only they are named. So here, this tejwala, the bull operators or the tejwala operators, they expect a rise in price of securities. Understand? So they will be expecting for a rise in price. Now they purchase their securities. Now they purchase and expect them for the increase in price. That time they will sell their securities. Understand? So in the future date they will sell their securities for a higher price. Now they will purchase at a lower price. Understand? So why they are called bull? Because they are expecting a higher price in future, because they like a bull. What a bull does when a victim comes, it will attack, it will throw it up in the air and it will attack. The same way this operators also expect a rise in price in future. Okay, that's why they are called bull operators. Okay, many speculators are available in the market. Now second one, so here we can say this bull operators as optimistic speculators. They are also called optimistic. What is the meaning optimistic? That positive thinker, we say. Understand? What they expect a rise in price, that's why they are called optimistic speculators. Okay, then the second one, bear operators. This bear operator is also called mandiwala. Understand? Bear operator is also called mandiwala speculator. Okay, mandiwala or bear. Here, just opposite of the bull or tejwala, he expects a fall in price. Understand? This mandiwala, he expects a fall in price in future. What he does? He sells his securities at a... Now he will sell, and in future he is expecting a fall in price. That time he will purchase the securities. Understand? They will sell the securities and waiting for the fall in price of securities. That time they will purchase their securities. So less price they are purchasing and for more price they are selling. Everybody is doing the same only, but here he is expecting a fall in price. That is why they are called bear or mandiwala. Why he is named after this bear? Because here the mandi, the bear, what does it do? It will push that victim to the ground and it will attack. That's why this mandiwala operators, the speculators are also expecting a fall in price. Understand? This speculator is also known as pessimistic speculator. Pessimistic speculator. Because pessimistic in the negative thought. They are thinking always that the price should go down. When the price goes down, they will purchase, and little bit if the price increases, they will sell the securities. Understand? Next one, stag. What is a stag? Stag is a deer with beautiful horns. That is called stag. Okay, deer family. Why is this? Some of the speculators are called a stag means the stag is very cautious. Okay, in the same way, these speculators are also very cautious. They are cautious speculator. And what does they expect? What do they do? They are different from these two speculators. They apply for the shares in new companies. In new companies, and what they do? They are expecting for the allotment. Before allotment, they will sell their shares for a premium. For premium, they will sell. Understood? Usually, they will apply for the share and application money. Then, before allotment, what they will do? They will sell their shares. Here, they are expecting a premium. That for profit, for gain only, they will sell their shares before allotment. Understand? The after application, the company will ask for the payment of allotment money. Before calling for the allotment, this speculators will sell their shares. Usually they will apply for the companies who are famous companies. Only then they can gain profit. Okay. These speculators are also called as premium hunter. Why they are called premium hunter? Because they are just waiting for the collection of premium. For premium only they will sell their securities. If they have purchased for 10 rupees of each share, they will sell at least for 12 rupees. Just waiting for the premium to be received. Okay, that's why they are called premium hunters. Then the last one is lame duck. It is related to the bear mandiwala speculator. What does this bear speculator does? He is waiting for the fall in price. That time he will purchase the securities. Understand? So this is connected with the bear speculator. Why? This lame duck. Because it is lame duck means the duck which is not able to walk, isn't it? Cannot walk. So this bear speculator is waiting for the fall in price. That time if the price does not fall, why? The shareholders, they are not ready to part with their securities. Understand? The shareholders are not ready to sell their securities. As they have expected, all the shareholders are not ready to sell. So they are not able to purchase the securities at low price. That time he is considered as the lame duck. He is not able to purchase them, and afterwards they cannot sell them at higher rate, isn't it? So that time we can say that they are the lame duck. They are suffering like the lame duck. Understood? But he is struggling like a lame duck because he is finding very difficult to fulfill his commitment. Understood? All the four that speculators, types of speculators, all these four types of speculators are the answers of two 3 mark question. First one, Roman number 3, that second question. Okay, then first two, then the second two, third question. So you have to learn this, all the four types of speculators. Okay, in the stock exchange, including this speculators, some other people are also there to trade securities, to help in the stock exchange, to help the people to purchase and sell securities. One among them are the remisers. The remisers are acting as an agent. Understand? Remisers are acting as an agent of the member of the stock exchange. Remisers are acting as agents of members of the stock exchange. Then what he does? He is working for his principal. Okay. Here he is, remiser is the agent. Then who is the principal? The member of the stock exchange. He is the principal. One who has appointed the agent is called the principal. Employer-employee relationship, we say. Here what is the relationship they have? Agent-principal relationship. If remiser is the agent, member is the principal. So he gets business. So he gets orders for his principal. Understand? Who is the principal? The member of the stock exchange. And he gets commission for his service. Understand? He gets commission for his service. They are called the remisers. Who are remisers? They are the agents of the members of the stock exchange. He gets business for his principal. The principal means his member. And he gets commission for his service. Understood? Then the authorized clerks. Authorized clerks. Clerks, we know, they are the employees. Authorized clerks are the employees appointed by whom? The members. By the members. Here the members appoint some agents. Again, the members only will transact business. Okay. So again, the members are appointing employees. So for salary only they will be working. No commission. They are receiving a monthly salary. Plus some commission. A percentage of commission they may receive as per their quantity of business. Okay, salary plus commission will be received by this authorized clerks. Here also they are working on behalf of their members. Everybody, because he is, since the member is appointing the employee, he will work for the employer, isn't it? Employee-employer relationship. On behalf of their employer, they will work. Where? In the floor of stock exchange. I told you that trade will be going on in a particular floor, maybe the first floor, I think, in the stock exchange. They are paid a salary plus a percentage of commission. Understood? The authorized clerks. Then the third one are brokers. They are the brokers. They are the brokers. We know brokers are the commission agent. We know broker means agent, isn't it? Commission agent. They'll be receiving a percentage of commission. Here, these agents will be acting in between the buyers and sellers. How they are acting? In between the buyers and sellers of securities. But they never buy or sell. Understand? They never buy and sell the securities, but they are acting in between the middleman, the broker. Understand? Middleman between the buyers and the sellers in the stock exchange. But they never buy on their own. Understand? What they do? They bring together all the buyers and sellers together and they help them in their deal. Understand? Help them to buy and sell. They bring them everyone together and help them to buy and sell the securities. But here they are getting, the brokers are getting brokerage. The agents will get a commission, brokers will get a brokerage. But this brokerage will be got both from the buyers and from the sellers. Because if a person comes to sell his security, he will get a commission from the seller. And the same security will be sold to a buyer because the buyer is coming there to buy the security. So from both the parties, he will get the commission or the brokerage. Okay, he will get brokerage from both the parties. So here these brokers, they are well versed. They are experts in the trends of marketing. They will say which securities will be in an increasing trend. So they will advise their buyers and sellers to buy and sell a particular type of securities because they are well versed in the trend of markets. Understand? So they will help the buyers and sellers to buy and sell the correct securities because they have full knowledge about all the securities. Then the fourth one, jobbers. Who are the jobbers? Again, jobbers are the merchants. Understand? They are the merchants. Security merchants. What they buy and sell? Merchants means the traders, isn't it? They are the merchants. They are dealing in the securities. Okay, the share, debenture, everything. Debentures. What does a merchant will do? He will purchase and he will keep in his hand and he will sell. In the same way, these jobbers also, they are the independent operators. They will buy and they will keep the securities in their hand and they will sell those securities to other people, the public. Okay, they buy and sell on their own behalf. Then if there is increase in price, they will earn. Okay, the merchant, what they will do? Ordinary market, they will purchase in large quantity from the wholesale market and they will sell in the retail market for the customers. In the same way, they will purchase and in their own name and they will sell for the public, those who are wishing to buy the securities. And if there is increase in price, they will earn. But here, they will not get any commission because they are not helping the buyers and sellers, but they can sell the securities. That's all. Commission is not allowed for this jobbers. Here we can say in India they are called Taravani Walas. So who is called Taravani Walas? Jobbers. Jobbers are also called as Taravani Walas in India. Understood? Then the next one, speculation, speculators. That word we have studied already, isn't it? Speculation. So if there is more fluctuation in price, fluctuation, increasing, decreasing, understand? If there is more fluctuation in the price of securities, these speculators will help in the stabilization of this fluctuation. They will stabilize the price of securities. Stabilize the price of securities. What they do, the speculator? If there is very less supply or more supply, the speculators will hold some of the securities in their own in order to wait for the more demand. Once demand has started to increase, they will release those securities. That is called speculation. Then the last term is gambling. Gambling, we have heard in Tamil, Sudata, isn't it? So that one, if there is no reasoning in gambling, no rules and regulation, we can say it is illegal. No government will recognize, authorize the playing gambling. Okay, it is illegal. Then no ethics, unethical. Unethical, we can say. So it is does not performing an economic function. Whether it increases the economy of the country? No. Okay, no economic function is there. It is not performing any economic function. So gambling is not at all related to this stock exchange, but they have given one word, meaning of gambling. Understood now? Now the next heading, the differences between stock exchange and commodity exchange. We know the stock exchange. What is commodity exchange? There we buy and sell the goods. Okay, goods market. Here stock market. What are the differences? First one is the meaning. We know what is stock exchange. It is also called stock market. Share market, isn't it? Stock market, share market. So it is one of the kind of capital market. Capital market. That capital market is divided into primary market and secondary market. That secondary market, one of the best example is stock exchange. So it is one of the type of capital market. All what we know about the stock exchange, it is also called stock market, share market. It is one of the kind of capital market. Now we can say, what is stock exchange? It is an organized market. We know it is, isn't it? It is an organized market because it is organized by central organization is there. Central government has to recognize the establishment of this stock exchange. So we can say it is an organized market. Why? For the purpose. Why it is established? For the purpose of purchase and sale of securities. For the purpose of purchase and sale of securities. What are the securities? Industrial and financial securities. Okay, we know all the things. Only one or two sentences enough. It is organized by the some certain rules and regulations. That also we can write. But what is commodity market? Commodity market is an exchange where commodities are bought and sold. Okay, commodities. It is an exchange where commodities are bought and sold. Bought and sold only trading, buying and selling is trading. So here, what type of commodities are sold and bought? Well, here we can say the metals. What are the metals? Iron, copper, silver, gold, everything. Then energy, all kind of energy, that gas, gold, coal. Then from that lignite, no, we take. Then water, all these will be coming under the energy. Then agricultural products, you know, rice, wheat, okay. Agricultural, then livestock and meat. All these are the commodities that are bought and sold in the commodity exchange. Here we know of what are the securities. Securities of industrial and financial securities. Industrial and financial securities. What are the industrial and financial securities? We can say the share, debentures, bonds. Okay, all these will come under the securities. Here, metals, energy, agricultural, livestock, and meat. All these are bought and sold. That is commodity market. Understood the meaning? The second one is function. The stock exchange, it is providing easy marketability, that we know, we easily we can buy and sell. So it provides easy marketability. Okay. Here, it is providing liquidity services. But they can easily sell the particular product and they can convert that into liquidity service will be provided in the commodity exchange. They can convert their commodities into cash. Here they can market, they can buy or sell their securities easily in the stock exchange. Understood? Then third point, object. What is the main object of this stock exchange? Here, main object, main aim is to facilitate capital formation. We know they are collecting. That means the savings of the people are converted into, they are diverted towards the productive purposes. So, capital formation, and they are making use of the capital resources. Capital resources are made for the best utilization of the capital resources. Okay, capital formation and capital resources are used optimistically by the companies because of the stock exchange. That is their main object. Here, they have to facilitate goods flow. They have to facilitate, they are providing facilities. Goods flow, they have the goods are from the manufacturer, it will be transported to the ultimate buyer. That's why they are facilitating goods flow. That means it is reducing the risk. Can we buy go and buy from the manufacturer, from the manufacturing point? No. Here what they are doing, they are providing transporting facilities to bring the goods from the manufacturer to the consumer, to the retail market. So that is their object, commodity exchange. Okay, then the fourth one is participants. Who are the participants in both the market? Who are the participants? Participants are in the stock exchange, who the investors who are investing their money in the stock, that is share, and the speculators. Speculators means all the members, then jobbers, agents, that remiser, isn't it? Remiser, then clerks, authorized clerks, all these people are speculators. So all these people are there in the stock exchange. Who? The investors and the speculators are available in the stock exchange. In the commodity market, who are the participants? The producers, that means the manufacturers. Then middlemen, they are called the dealers. Then traders, they are, we can say, the traders, buyers and sellers, and the body of speculators. Here also we can say the speculators, that those who, that middlemen only will acting as the speculators. Understood? So producers, dealers, traders and speculators are available in the commodity exchange, but here only investors and speculators are available in the stock exchange. Fifth point is period of dealings, whether immediately or future. Okay, period of dealing. Here, within all the cash payment or everything must be done within a fortnight. What is fortnight? Within 14 days time. Okay, within 14 days time they have to complete the dealings. May either the payment of cash may be done, but within 14 days, that called fortnight. Okay, either the cash delivery also will be there, cash payment, then ready delivery, but any other dealings that must be finished within a period of 14 days. Understand? In the commodity market it may be same, that means cash dealings. Okay, or here the credit dealings must be completed within either 1 month or 2 month or 3 month period. At the most 3 month period they have to complete the future dealings. Understand? Credit dealings or cash, that means that instant payment of cash, the cash delivery, cash dealings. Cash dealings on the same day it will get completed, isn't it? But if they are credit dealings, it must be completed at the maximum of 3 months. That is the period of dealing. Okay. Here this question, differences between stock exchange and commodity exchange is on that answer of 4 mark question. Okay, 4 mark question. 4th one, differences between stock exchange and commodity exchange. So you have to write at least 6-7 points. Okay, many points are given there, around 10 points are there. You have to learn at least 6-7. So listen carefully now. What is the 6th point? Articles traded. What are the articles they are traded? They are trading. Here already we studied, isn't it? Industrial securities and financial securities. That you can write. Industrial securities. What are the industrial securities? Shares, debentures, bonds, and the financial securities are the government securities. Okay, you can write on financial securities or government securities. Understood? Government securities. So industrial securities such as shares, debentures, bonds, etc. And the financial securities are the government securities. All these securities are dealt with in the stock exchange. Here in the commodity exchange, what type of articles are traded? Durable goods, that metals, energy, isn't it? Durable goods. The same thing also you can write. Okay, metals, energy, agricultural, livestock and meat. Here durable goods are traded, then or graded goods are traded. Okay, the same thing also you can write. The metals, energy, everything also you can write. Okay, the next one, seventh one. The seventh point, speculation. So here the speculation is that is good for this stock exchange. Okay, what does it do? The speculation ensure stability of securities or saleability of securities. Saleability of securities. We can sell them because of this speculation. They anyhow they will if it is not today, the next day we can sell them. So for that they are helping the speculators. We can sell them because there is liquid and continuous market. They are only helping for the ready market because there is no off season in this stock exchange. So they are controlling the demand and the supply of securities, the speculators. So they ensure the saleability of securities because they provide ready market or they provide liquid and continuous market. Okay, that is same meaning. Liquid market, we can convert them into cash, and it is ready market, continuous market. Here what does speculation does? Here also it is reducing the price risk. It is reducing the price risk. Then the eighth one, forward contract. Here, forward contract means that forward dealings, future dealings. Future dealings are all standardized in the stock exchange. They can do. Understand? Future dealings are forward dealings, forward contracts. All these are fully standardized in the stock exchange. As per their standard only, they can do this future dealings. Understand? Standardized means that standard will be there. As per their standards only, they can do this future dealings. Here also they have the future dealings. Here already not standardized, their standards are to be fixed. Standards to be fixed. In future, it will be fixed. For the future contract. Understand? It is not available now, but the standards is to be fixed. Ninth one, cornering. Here, the cornering means the control of some of the securities. No securities can be controlled, no, ineffectively. So they can get the securities. One particular security cannot have the full control. Understand? Here cornering is very easy. Easy in the stock exchange, but here cornering is very difficult. Because what is that cornering? That control of one particular product in the market. That is very difficult here. But here it is very easy. The last one, price quotation.
here price quotation for the future dealings. Only one quotation will be available. Okay, we know that price quotation will be shown in the electronic board. So only one quotation for future dealings, to when to buy or sell, only one quotation will be available. Only one rate, understand? But for here, for the commodity market, many quotation, okay, multiple quotations are available. Each person can sell their commodities in different prices, isn't it? But here there is no, only one price quotation is available for the future dealings in stock exchange. But here multiple quotations are available for the commodities in the commodities exchange. Understood all the 10 points I have explained to you. Read once again. If you find any point very tough to understand, you leave them. 10 do not need to write. At least 6-7 you have to write. They may ask for 5 marks. Okay, if you write 10, it is well and good. Okay, students, you study these question answers and we will complete the lesson by tomorrow. Thank you, students.